Hello and welcome to Haynes Oval in Broome for the semi-final being played today, the Women's WKFL between Cable Beach Footy Club and Towns Football Club. They are both Broome-based teams and they finished first and second on the ladder. So they play in the first semi-final today as the captains meet in the middle. That is Skye Jamieson for Towns and Maddie Jelly for Cable Beach. They're going to do the toss, and it looks like Towns have won the toss and elected to kick to the airport end of the ground. It is a beautiful day for football here in Broome, and we're looking forward to an interesting clash. Towns coming off a win last weekend, and Cable Beach have had a couple of games missed due to forfeits. I joked with them last week, no one wants to play against them, they're just too good. But that will probably hinder their preparation for this final series as they're a bit out of practice, out of match practice. Nevertheless, both teams look very good. I'm going to be joined in commentary today by my old mate, Maddie Francis.
G'day,
welcome,
Ross.
Maddie.
Yeah, pleasure to be here. Interesting you mentioned. So the Cable Beach, are they undefeated as yet? The Cable Beach women's team?
Absolutely undefeated.
Wow.
They weren't able to do all of the games, though, because, as I said, a couple of teams had forfeited against them last weekend. They missed out with Derby not being able to make field a side coming down from Derby last weekend.
So missed a few games, but hopefully still been training.
Yes, I'm sure they have been training. As for Towns, this is their first proper season. They trained all last season. Of course, the WKFL didn't happen last year due to COVID restrictions. But they have done so well to finish second. So we're watching first and second. It's the first of the semi-finals. And the siren sounds to get us underway. Tim Clear holds the ball up, throws it up. And we're underway. Cable Beach winning the first tap of the match. It's held up a bit in the centre. Towns kicks it clear. It's picked up there by Watson. And it's got as far as looks like Isabel Varney in the centre of the ground. She kicks forward for Cable Beach. It's on the high school side. Hand pass away. And they're content to sort of dive on top of it. Slow things up a bit. Townies with the ball now on the high school side, the furthest away from us that you can get on the broadcast wing here at Haynes. Running onto it strongly, but overran it in the end. That was long, Janika for Towns. And the Towns ended up with a free kick. They've played on quickly. It's into the goal square. Is it a goal in the first couple of minutes?
Close.
Vinicum. Townies supporters like it. Townies supporters like it. So, within the first couple of minutes of the match, we have Vinicum for Towns. She's lined it up, kicked around the body. She's kicked a goal. What a way to get their finals hopes going. Townies with a big crowd here supporting them this morning. And it is Towns on the board.
Lovely work, an early start from the Towns. Now, whoever wins this game, they go straight to the grand finals, is that right?
That's exactly right. So this is one versus two, so the winner of this match goes straight through to the grand final being played on Saturday 11th of September, and the loser plays the winner of three versus four, which is happening later on today, and that will be next weekend in the preliminary final. So it's a good game to win, gets you a secured grand final berth. Find ourselves back in the centre now. This time no one really winning the tap. A big mob of players chasing after it. Looks like Leanne Gubbins leading the charge there. Being picked up by Jaleika Stewart, fighting hard for Towns. Towns are pumped now with that early goal on the board. Picked up by Gubbins. And they're fighting hard. That looks like one of the Augustine girls. It is Sanchez with the ball there for Cable Beach. Back and forward footy at the moment. Finds it in the lap of Kenworthy for Towns. Jamieson also for Towns, trying to get the ball away. Spills to Varney. Varney kicks a clearing kick towards the broadcast wing. Lani Pigram with a beautiful pickup. Unfortunately, unable to finesse the bounce, but she gets the handball away to Pepita Wilson. Wilson kicks it forward, looking for Dan. Dan picks it up, handball back over to Pigram. Pigram back to Dan. Dan, a centering kick. This time the ball just sort of wobbling around on the ground there. Picked up by Winetti. She loves those sort of kicks. Not sure what the umpire has pulled out there, but he's bringing it back, I believe. I'm not really sure. I missed that signal there, and I'm not looking to Maddie for technical assistance today. It's very much special comments, aren't you, Maddie?
I'm getting the weather ready. I'll let you know how it's going to treat her players later.
Excellent. Lani Pigram in the thick of it again, wearing the headpiece, the helmet. Easy to spot, number 5 for Cable Beach. Content to give the ball to the field umpire, who's going to ball it up. Not too far from the Cable Beach bench. So they're getting a lot of cheers out there. Lani Pigram disposes of her opponent. Gets a kick away, looking for Parryman to pick it up. Overruns it. Looked like in the back there to me, but the umpire content to let it play on. This is a great game of footy. The skill level of these two teams just shows us why they finished first and second on the women's WKFL ladder.
Yeah, and getting straight into that grand final would be a lovely thing to do. So I think both teams are working real hard to get there.
Absolutely. Towns defence with the pick up there, kicks it out. But a beautiful mark. That looked like Elena Coffin. Yes, it was. She's got that lovely long plait. Easy to spot her. She kicks it to the half forward for Cable Beach, where it's picked up again by Leanne Gubbins. Looked like she ran a little bit too far, but she got a kick away. She's been everywhere already. Oh,
wow.
Strong tackle and play. Elena Coffin, the two number 19s going at it then. Not quite sure who's been awarded the free kick, but I think Coffin's ended up with it because she laid such a strong tackle. She pushes forward again for Cable Beach. Once again, Towns are able to cut it off at that half forward mark, but only as far back to Varney in the centre of the ground. Cable Beach just struggling across their half forward there. It's been a 50 metre penalty awarded. By the look of the umpire jogging backwards there.
Yeah, what brought that on?
Not sure.
Okay.
Perhaps the run over the mark. I'm not sure. We'll see. Not watching the TV screen. There's too much action going on around here, right in front of us.
Number 15, Steph, running out. I can see that.
Yeah, that's for Rone. She's coming on for Cable Beach as her teammate Varney lines up for goal. Hasn't quite got the distance. Popped up high into the square for Cable Beach. No one able to take a mark. Catherine Dan there with a strong presence, trying to pick up the ball. It spills to Wilson. Wilson handballs to Dan, and Dan's kicked it through for a goal for Cable Beach. Scores are level.
Lovely work. Yeah, Cable Beach, one goal, and Towns, one goal. So nice level scores, only about 4 minutes. 26 into this game.
So tell us about the weather, Maddie. What's happening today? What can we expect?
It's looking lovely. Right now we've got 28 degrees, only with a max of 29 here in Broome. And those wind speeds, pretty gentle. Nice enough to keep you cool, but not enough to really throw the game off, I reckon.
You are an expert at this. Well done.
Yeah.
It's great to have you with me today.
I can talk general about a lot of things.
My name is Roz. I love coming and doing the footy commentary. And today, sharing it with Maddie Francis, which is an added bonus.
For the
bonus.
First time. It's a lovely thing.
Lovely thing. We go up for the ruck again. Again, no one really winning it. But the Cable Beach player tapped it forward. Unfortunately, not to the advantage of her player. And Stewart has the ball now for Towns. Kicks it forward. Coffin overran it for Cable Beach. Dragging it in. And a free kick has been awarded there. Again, missing the umpire's signal. But it's Cable Beach on their half back line to kick clear through Watson. Watson pops it up nicely, though. And a mark's being taken by Stewart. Jaleika Stewart getting a bit of the action early here today. It's the first time I've seen Towns play this year. Hasn't really worked out with the timing of the filming. As we see Winetti spins away with the ball. She kicks, and she kicks truly. What a great kick. What a great kick. Beg your pardon, that was Leanne Gubbins. Picked it up over near the cricket nets, the high school side of the ground, put it on to her boot, and it floated through for a beautiful goal to Towns. have kicked truly already. Towns 2-0, 12. Cable Beach 1-6. We're at the 6.25 minute mark.
At this rate, I think it must be Cable Beach's turn for a goal next. Is that how this works?
Back and forward. People do call it ping pong, this game of ours. But I'm not sure that Townies will be hoping that's the way it works, or Cable Beach either, for that matter. They'd be wanting to get... They're used to being a couple of goals clear by now.
That's
very
it.
Strong competitors this year. Favourites for the flag. It's Augustine gets it clear for Cable Beach out of the centre again. But again, it's picked up
kick.
At that half-back for Towns.
Brought right back to her. There she is again.
Coffin again with the ball. She's chased by Jamison. Strong tackle. And beautiful pick-up by Brooks of Towns as far as Gubbins.
That's got to be, that's a push.
Yeah, in the back there. I feel like Gubbins played for that one, but anyway, she was in the right position.
Nice. Went straight into
she
the play.
She quickly plays on.
Oh, again.
As far as long for Towns, over to Jamison, the captain. Jamison kicking towards goal. Great-looking kick. It's in the forward pocket for Towns. The Cable Beach defender unable to just drop it the timing on her boot.
Yeah.
She's ended up with the ball again, though. That's Augustine for Beach. Back to Coffin. Coffin kicks into the woman right on the mark. Again, Govins there trying to get that free kick. Unable to. Gets the handball off the ground. Spills to Brooks.
Good pass work.
Brooks
oh, but
gets the handball.
Cable Beach.
Handball to Coffin. And here comes... Seward for Cable Beach. The ball in the centre of the ground. It's dribbled forward. Varney picks it up. Varney kicks the ball clear. But again, it's blocked off. That half forward line for Cable Beach. They need to work on that. Maybe they need to push Catherine Dan up a little bit higher. Just not getting it through that half forward line. Cable Beach.
I'm also seeing a lot of loose players. There aren't a lot of players
That's
on
right.
players out there.
You're exactly right, Maddie. They're not playing that sort of one-on-one defence that we're used to from some of the other teams who are just learning the game. Maybe that's a tactic
Towns
for both of these
possession.
Teams.
And back into their, heading towards their goals.
Yeah, that's Sky Jamison with the ball there. She
passed
pass it off to Brooks. Brooks gets a big kick. It lands at the front of the square, but it's clear through. From Augustine, gets a kick away.
She's been doing some good defence work there, actually.
She has.
She's brought it out a few times.
And you know what's good about the Augustine girls? They're spread out across the ground, so we can call all four of them and pretty much get it right.
An all good scene in each pocket, eh?
Exactly. Pocket or something, Maddie.
What's up? Wing, around, game, field.
You got it. You got the vocabulary. The umpire has called a free kick there. This time it is going the way of Cable Beach. They're in their defence, so they'll be happy with that kick. And they kick it as far as Jelly. Maddie Jelly, the captain for Cable Beach, in possession of the ball at their half-back line. She kicks towards the centre of the ground. Stewart missed what she should have taken. Ends up with another Augustine. Gubbins picks up the ball, gets the kick away. Now it's in the Towns forward line. Chasing towards it. And again, it's mopped up by Cable Beach. This time, Varney has it. Shrugs one tackle. Kicks forward. Dan with the ball.
Here
she's going to take a bounce and have a run.
She's
what can she
room.
Make of this? Come on, Catherine. Put another goal on the board for Cable Beach. Carstairs, uncustomary dropping of that mark. Still tries to get the kick away. And it's now in the square for Cable Beach. Held up by Towns. Cable Beach were hoping for a holding the ball there, but she didn't really have the opportunity to get rid of it. So the umpire is going to do a risky ball up right in the Cable Beach square. Catherine Dan trying to wrestle that ball
out.
No
chance of getting it out of there. That was a very, very close little group.
And we're going to have another ball up. This time, Parriman says, I'll take the ruck tap. No one really winning it, though. It's ended up on the ground again. Tell you who's been everywhere for Towns. It's number 10. And that is Leanne Gubbins. She's the vice captain for Towns. She's been up and down the length of that ground.
Ball's moving out. Back to Cable Beach.
That was little Bev Edgar with the ball there, number 11 for Cable Beach. Just being held up by Towns. They're playing a very good defensive game. Get the ball clear again. Not far enough for a mark, though. High up and under kick.
Great
and
mark.
Coffin is underneath it for Cable Beach.
Could have saved it.
Coffin takes a couple of steps back, settles herself for the kick. We're now in half forward proper for Cable Beach. Parriman unable to take the mark. Pushes the ball off, pushes the Towns player off the ball though. Definite presence down there for Cable Beach, Caitlin Parriman. And the ball comes clear through Stewart again.
Middle of the grounds now, heading back towards Cable Beach.
Brooks is there for Towns. Get it clear again. Coffin again. She would be leading our stats. We'll check in with Will Cameron, our statistician, at quarter time. See exactly what is happening. We'll see a lot of inside 50s for Cable Beach, but not the goals converting. It's really an area that Coach McAlbert will need to be working on. The ball comes back to the centre of the ground again. What a surprise. Coffin with the ball. There's young Bev Edgar. Isabel Varney for Cable Beach. This is hard and tough footy.
Both teams want it so much. Yeah.
First semi-final, we're at the 12 and a half minute mark. This is 1 versus 2 in the women's WKFL. You're listening live on Galari Radio. Or perhaps you're watching a replay through GTV, Galari Media. The ball again is in the middle of the ground. As two players go at it to try and spill it free. Tui Winetti was hovering there. But it's Stewart who's been able to get the kick away. This time it's over to the high school side. And another big kick. As the siren sounds, we must
there
have not put our timer on quite in time, but that's okay. The siren sounds to mark the end of a very interesting first quarter.
Yeah, so we've got Cable Beach with 1 goal, 6, and Towns, 2 goals, 12 for the first quarter.
Very nice kicking for both teams. Usually in the West Kimberley Footy League women's, we do see a bit of, not so much accuracy, but that's beautiful kicking. And Towns with the ascendancy right now, we're hoping to hold on to that and secure their place in the grand final in a couple of weeks' time. Will we catch up with Will after the break? Yes, we will. We'll catch up with our statistician after the break. In the meantime, it is quarter time for the qualifying final between Cable Beach and Towns. Welcome back to Haynes Oval, where we are watching this first semi-final. Cable Beach Footy Club versus Towns. They finished first and second, respectively, in the women's WKFL, and they're fighting for the right for that grand final berth. Let's welcome for the first time today our resident statistician, Mr. Will Cameron. Morning, Will.
Morning, Ros. Tying the free kicks 2-2, also tying the clearances 2-2, and Towns leading the hit-outs 2-1.
Oh, and I see you're not doing the inside 50s for me today, and that's the one I was really interested about. Okay, because I know that Beach had it a lot inside their 50 and they just weren't able to convert. So what you've shown us there is very much what we're seeing on the scoreboard. With 1 goal, 6, Cable Beach trailing Towns currently 2 goals, 12. So just 1 goal, the difference here at Haynes Oval in Broome, and a beautiful day for football, as I welcome back my co-commentator, Maddie Francis.
G'day, Roz.
Did you have a couple of snakes at
quarter
time?
I did, actually. I got my own orange ones.
You got your own orange ones? And I thought that was just for the main talent around here.
No, it was a mixed bag. There was just orange in there.
A mixed bag. That sounds like Galari team, doesn't it?
That's it.
A mixed bag. All right. As we see the other field umpire for today, David Burke, he's about to do the honours and throw the ball up. In the centre of the ground. Got the ruck, Monique Criddle for Towns. And she has got the height over her opponent, which is not sure actually what happened then. But anyway, we're underway again, the second quarter. Live footy action. This is a semi-final. We're fighting for a place, the big dance on Saturday, the 11th of September. There we go. Wanetti with the ball, kicks it clear. Drops for Lani Pigram, plays
straight
on with
it.
A bounce, avoids a,
oh, wow.
Avoids a thing.
Ooh,
oh, I
that
just got
amazing.
All tongue-tied. I was expecting that to be amazing. Great play from Lani Pigram. She was obviously listening to the coach at quarter time, because Coach Mick Albert said to the Cable Beach forwards, use our speed, use our agility, and we will be able to keep pushing forward. Use our strengths.
Yeah, ducking and weaving. That was great.
Not able to finish off there, Lani Pigram, and it spills through for a behind for Beach.
Close to being, and it's out. Yep.
Okay, the ball spills out. And in the women's footy, if it's a clear off another player, another team, beg your pardon, then it's a kick in. Otherwise, we do a throw in. That's what's happening right now. Nice throw in from the boundary umpire there. Criddle able to get the tap away, but not to her team's advantage. She has the ball again, Criddle. Oh, Wanetti fighting hard for the ball, but not sure that she was actually looking at the ball when she laid that tackle. Nevertheless, the ball spills to Catherine Dan. She handballs it over the boundary line, it looked like. Brooks picks it up, keeps it in play for Towns, kicks it forward for Towns. We're in the Cable Beach forward line currently. And they're fighting hard at the airport end of the ground. Coffin on the ground there. The ball not able to be spilled free. And the umpire says, yes, please. And we've got a ball up. Criddle gets the tap on. She taps it to the advantage of Towns, though. Kenworthy for Towns kicks the ball to the centre of the ground. It's picked up by Cable Beach. Looked like a high tackle there. The coach of Cable Beach agrees with me. Cooper, beg your pardon, Watson there for Cable Beach. The ball is back again in the centre of the ground. Looks like Abby Dorfling trying to just kick it along the ground and push it forward as per the coach's instructions. So he'd be happy that they've been listening to him. Mick Albert, yeah, great footy, Abby, agrees with me. And the ball is going to be thrown in just inside, just near the cricket nets on the high school side of the oval. No real breeze to speak of.
No, it's dropped
right
down.
Advantage in that respect. Wow. Strong mark taken by Tui Wanetti.
Running straight
forward. Wanetti
for
kicks forward.
Nice mark.
And right on the chest of Sienna Carstairs, who is the current leading goal kicker for the women's WKFL. It's tied at the top with all Cable Beach players holding about the first four or five positions in the goal kicking tally. Carstairs leading them all, and she runs in again. This time looks a little bit to the left hand side. Maybe it was picked up
maybe
by
the
a
wind
bit
just
of
at
a
the
breeze.
Very end. Yeah, picked up a bit, just drifted it off, but that's a it's behind.
And Josh Linton, the goal umpire, signals another behind.
Cable Beach, 1-2-8, and Towns, 2 goals for 12. So it's still a very close game, second quarter right now. Both teams really, really want it. The scores are low because the competition is absolutely fierce between these two teams.
Absolutely right, as Sanchez finds herself with the ball right in front of the goal, a bit far
out
to
score. Wow,
great
mark, and good spot.
But the strength of Catherine Dan, she was able to hold her player right up until the last minute when she popped her head up and said, thank you, I'll have that.
It's a name
and now she's
up.
Lining up for a goal. Yes, expect Catherine Dan to be a star performer today and in the grand final if they make it there.
How's
and that,
that look?
Is a goal on the board for Cable Beach.
Yes.
Yes, two flags. One flag, a point for Cable Beach. Goodness me.
Yeah, it
and I even
close.
Had the binoculars on there too.
Yeah, it was really close.
So that score is 2-2-14. Oh, wait, that might be wrong because it wasn't a goal.
Yeah, that was behind. There we are.
All right, we'll wait.
1-3-9 for Cable Beach and 2-12 for Towns. Still, though, it's hard to get it out. I mean, every time they Towns tries to get it out of the Cable Beach forward, they have a mark and have another go.
Absolutely. This time, Winetti with the sniff of the ball there. 2-on-1. Well played by Towns. Ooh. There. Were able to get their kick away.
That was bouncing,
Kennedy
bouncing.
For Towns.
Still in.
Ball still in. Looked like in the back from Augustine, but gets away with it. Winetti ends up with the ball, kicks it to Augustine. That's Sanchez. Sanchez with a rubbish old kick, but yeah. Anyway, it does the job, pushes them forward, back to Winetti again, on her left, her preferred kicking foot. And we've got the ball in the Cable Beach forward line yet again. I can hear Mick Albert's going to have a very sore voice this afternoon. He calls to his players. Cable Beach coach I'm talking about there. The ball is held up. It's now in possession of Towns. They try to clear it out of their defence. Looking for Sky Jamison. She's only able to deflect that from being a mark, though. It's fallen now. It looks like Brooks with the ball.
Zipped in.
For Towns. Seems like she's got lots of time, that player. But Kenworthy ran out of time. Coffin gets it on the boot. Pushes forward for Cable Beach. Running on with it, Lani Pigram and Catherine Dan. What can they do together? Pigram skirts around another one. Has her second chance of a goal today. This
that
time, the goal umpire marks it. So that is a goal for Cable Beach.
Now, in footy, if the goal umpire marks it, that's an extra? No, I don't think that's anything.
No, that's just Josh Linton trying to protect his pretty face, I think.
Good call.
2-3-15, Cable Beach. They now lead Towns 2-12. 3 points the difference.
Yes, Cable Beach just jumped ahead now. Still anyone's game at this point.
This is the second quarter. Got the women's WKFL. A bit more action coming later today. 1:30 Luma play Bombers. That's 3 versus 4. The winner of that will play the loser of this game next weekend. What's going on, Townies? Just having a bit of a change at the center bounce or center ball up. Once again, Coffin in the thick of things in the center of the ground. Running out with the Towns player. Townies playing a bit of soccer there. That was Kennedy for Towns. Lani Pigram in the thick of things right this quarter as well. Once again, trying to push forward for Cable Beach. Yep. We're in the Cable Beach half forward line.
And Towns are very keen to not let that happen.
Exactly. Here comes Catherine Dan. What can she do with it? She attempts a centering kick.
Nice
she passes it to Tui Winetti.
All right.
Now, in my experience watching Winetti, she is better on the run than she is with a set shot, as she lines herself up for a set shot on about a 45-degree angle.
Yeah, it's the moment
she's,
to show otherwise.
Just probably about 45 metres out as well, just inside the 50-metre mark. She likes her chances. She's doing a couple of spins of the ball. A few changes going on. Kicks
big
it through.
Deep kick.
What's she done with it? The Cable Beach supporters like it.
Yep.
And it's a goal.
It's a goal.
Another
one
goal
down.
To Cable Beach.
3-3-21 for Cable Beach and Towns 2 for a total of 12 in the second quarter.
Yeah, and in a game like this, I don't think you want your opposition to get a couple of goals clear. You want to keep it nice and tight. So Townies really need to answer here. So they'll look to their ruck now to win this tap and push the ball forward for an answer. Cable Beach have got a couple of goals, or at least been peppering around the goals for the last few minutes of this second quarter. Towns really need to get in on the action, just stay in touch.
Get a few more shots at it.
As it looks like the Cable Beach ruck won the bounce, but here we go through Kennedy with Towns. Kennedy to Gubbins. Gubbins not able to pick it up. Jamison picks it up off the ground, kicks it forward, overrun by the Cable Beach defender. 32 for Towns, trying to play a bit
Whoa.
Of soccer.
Did she
Has
soccer
that
it
gone
in?
Through? That's Mary Dan. I work with Mary. That's so exciting. Woohoo!
Wow, nice work.
She is the most lovely lady, very quiet, unassuming lady, to kick a goal in a semi-final, an important game, will just be delightful. Couldn't happen to a nicer lady.
Three,
well done,
three,
Mary
21.
Dan. And well done to Kennedy, who pushed it forward for Towns to get them into that position.
Quite a soccer, that one. Yeah, so now it's gotten a lot closer. 3-3-21 for Cable Beach. Towns 3 for a total of 18.
With the 10-minute mark of the second quarter. And Towns did just what I asked of them. Kept it nice and close. 3 points the difference now. And here we are again. You don't actually usually get that many goals kicked in a women's WKFL game. And to see, you know, 3 goals already is really good. We've got a good standard of competition here. So fighting to bring that ball out. Number 19 for Towns, that's Kenworthy. She had that look of grit and determination. She wasn't giving that ball up. So we see another ball up just inside the Towns forward. And Kira Watson is able to tap it off the ground. Varney comes away with it. Runs away, but only as far. That looks like Stewart there. Or is it Parsons? Parsons for Towns. And the ball is underneath. It looked a little bit like tunnel ball there. They weren't able to get it clear. And the umpire says, we'll have a ball up. Ball up goes the way of Towns, but only as far as the Cable Beach player, who forgot she was playing football for a minute there and has done an amazing throw. And the ball will come back. She looked straight at the umpire and said, yep, guilty as charged. It's almost
like someone's got to get the ball.
Was almost like she was playing volleyball. Anyway, no one's really keen to get the ball back to where it needs to go.
Thanks, number 5.
In the end, it was Brown for Towns who ran out of defence to
so
get
just
that
like
ball.
Playing on, just like that. All right, here we are.
Yep.
Towns in possession, moving it down towards their forward.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
That looks like Dorfling there with the ball. And just held on to it, wasn't able to get it clear. So they say we'll have another ball up.
Is anyone marking the amount of times that this has happened? Because this feels like a lot
I
for
know.
A game.
It does feel like a lot of times for this game. Maybe next year we'll have Will on more than just 3 yeah. stats. We'll bump up your responsibilities, Will. As we see, Gubbins for Towns. Kicks
oh,
forward.
They're going to do it again.
Could it make the distance? No, it doesn't quite make the distance. And they're diving on top of it down there. I see Cooper for Towns. I see Dan for Towns. And, of course, there's a few Cable Beach defenders who are very keen not to let it go through the big sticks. We see another ball up. This time it gets attempted to soccer out. A few hands on it. Off the ground. Off the ground. And what have they called it?
Gotta be a behind, yeah?
It's a behind. Yep. Umpire Pete Heal says touched off the boot. There were a lot of hands around that one. Townies liked it, but not quite.
First behind for the Towns as well. 3-3-21 now for Cable Beach. Towns 3-1-19.
2-point ball game here at Haynes Oval in Broome. This is 1 versus 2 in the women's WKFL. And they're putting on a show for us. The ball all of a sudden is back in the center of the ground. Got players diving on top of it. Picked up by Winetti. Winetti kicks on her favored left. Pigram unable to mark. Dan picks it up off the ground though, gets it back to Pigram. Pigram steals it out of the hands of the Towns defender, and it's on the chest of Carstairs. Sienna Carstairs will line up for her second goal of the match. She is about 45 metres out. And I like her chances from this distance and from this front-on angle.
Not a lot of time left of this quarter. This could be one of the last few attempts at goal.
How will Cable Beach finish the quarter? Did I put the mocker on her or has it gone through? No. Nah, that's a point. I'm sure he won't be dragging her, though. The leading goal kicker for the season, Sienna Carstairs, just not able to convert that one. And another point on the board. Cable Beach moved to 3-4-22, leading Towns 3-1-19. We'll wait for the siren, which is imminent. for half time, and the girls will be ready for a drink and a break, sit down.
A well earned, yep, a little half time break.
So although it is beautiful weather for us under the shade, it is still quite a warm day in Broome.
And there's the siren.
It is. Augustine will hang on to that ball, pass it over to the umpires to look after it during the half time break. And Towns and Cable Beach come off for a well earned break. It is a close game here. 3 points the difference at halftime. Cable Beach 3-4-22, leading Towns 3-1-19. We'll take a break for halftime and hopefully you can join us back here at Haynes Oval for the rest of this women's WKFL semi-final action. Welcome back to Haynes Oval in Broome, where we are watching or listening to West Kimberley Footy League women's action. It is the first semi-final. It's 1-2, playing for a right to get into the grand final on Saturday the 11th of September. It's Cable Beach versus Towns. Currently Cable Beach 3-4-22, Towns 3-1-19. 3 point difference, Cable Beach leading currently, as I reintroduce my friend Will Cameron with the stats.
Hey Ros, Towns leading the free kicks 1-0, Cable Beach leading the clearances 3-1, and Cable Beach also leading their hitouts 3-1.
Okay, that's interesting stats. Cable Beach really did come back at Towns in that quarter. Thanks so much for the stats, Will. We look forward to checking in with you again at three-quarter time. I went and had a hover over the Towns bench, or the Towns huddle at halftime. And it was very much rah-rah stuff. This is our time to shine, coach was saying. Just keep pushing forward, get around each other, support each other. We got this. My name's Roslyn Butcher. I'm joined in commentary with Maddie Francis. Welcome
hello.
Back, Maddie.
Yeah, hello, everyone. And lovely game here today. Intense game, actually.
Intense. Maddie's first time commentating with me today, and he's loving every minute of it as we see Tui Winnetti banging it on her left
straight
foot.
Off the bat.
And
wow.
Within the first 20 seconds of the game, Cable okay. Beach have said, we've come to play.
Look, whatever Mick said to them during that halftime break worked.
Well, I did send you over to see what technical stuff you could glean from the halftime huddle.
Stay on your feet.
What'd you get for me?
Stay on your feet and, you know, you can do this.
Kick goals. Kick them through the big sticks. And that's what Tui Winnetti has just done. That's the sort of goal that she likes the best. Running on her left foot, bangs it away. And this time it went through
like
for
lightning.
A goal. Sat sweetly for
in.
Them. Exactly. So Cable Beach moved to 4-4-28, Towns 3-1-19. Towns, we're all the talk about. Get around each other. We got this. Support each other. So they'd want to use that momentum now and answer that very quick goal in the third quarter to Cable Beach. Ball goes up in the centre of the ground. Towns win the tap, but only as far as Cable Beach. Picked up by Brooks. Brooks on to Long. Been pinged for a throw, I think. And the free kick coming back to Long. It's Janika Long for Town. She kicks forward. Brooks trying to run towards it, but Coffin beats her in the foot race. In the end, they all overrun it, and Brooks ends up on the ground. That looked also like a throw. But anyway, Kenworthy was able to get the kick forward for Towns. This has definitely been the scoring end of the game. With the exception, of course, of that very quick goal to Cable Beach just before. And here we are with Towns with another free kick, and they're lining up for a shot on goal. Pretty sure that looks like 17. Is it Kabili? Yeah. Janisha? Janisha lining up. She's about 40 metres out. Or did I call that as 45 before? Anyway, she has a long run up. Runs in, makes the distance, but it was a low stab of a kick. So it's attempted to mark right in the goal square. There's about six or seven players hovering around there. And the umpire is going to do a ball up right in the townie's square. Interesting, the goal square. Sky Jamison diving on top of it. Gubbins pulls it out of the pack.
If
kicks
that's a
it
goal,
over behind her body.
Like,
and it's a goal. And doesn't she love it?
What a game.
Leanne Gubbins.
That's brought it close. It's a Cable Beach now 4-4-28.
She is a strong player and she knows what to do in these big games. She picked that up off the ground, spun around a la Peter Wilson years ago for the West Coast Eagles. I don't know if anyone listening can remember that when he kicked it over his body to put the Eagles in front. Anyway, it moves Cable Beach 4-4-28. Towns 4-1-25. We're at the 3-minute mark of the third quarter and this is a cracker of a game. Great game. Very lucky that my 16s netball team didn't make the grand final.
Is that lucky?
So I can be here to watch and commentate this.
Well, silver lining.
Win-win either way, I guess. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have said that out loud. As Varney fights for the ball, it's in the Cable Beach forward line now, only as far as Ferone. Ferone puts it on her boot. Winnetti picks it up. Winnetti bangs it onto the boot. Catherine Dan pushing forward. Pigram overran it. Pigram again fighting hard for the ball for Cable Beach. Brings down the Towns defender, but it falls for Towns. And Towns get the clearing kick out of defence. It's in the centre of the ground in front of the broadcast wing. That's Kenworthy working hard for Towns. Jamison overruns it. The ball on the ground again. And four or five once again on top of the ball. This time... Cable Beach have been pinged for holding the ball. Captain for Towns, Skye Jamison, kicks the ball towards their forward line. Gaining a bit of ground, but the defenders for Cable Beach are working hard. Kira Watson from Cable Beach missing a shoe. So the runner goes out, or the water boy goes out to try and retrieve a shoe for Watson from Cable Beach. And the ball is now back in the possession of Cable Beach. They'll be very happy to clear it out of that Towns forward line. That pushed forward very quickly for Towns. Beach get the kick away.
Straight back to Towns.
Kennedy gets a front position, takes a mark, plays on quickly, kicks it up to her forward line. No one home for Towns though. And again, it's in the hands of the umpire. I know Maddie was mentioning earlier, there seems to be an inordinate number of ball ups in this game. Just shows the pressure that is being applied around the packs. Varney gets the ball out for Beach. Comes to Gubbins again. What can she do this time? This time kicked into the woman on the mark. Beach picks it up, trying to clear it out of there, banging it quickly onto their boot, but it's been marked by Malardi. That's Hayley Malardi for Towns. Don't think she's got the distance for this kick. In the end,
short
she just
kick.
Sort of taps
straight
at it.
To Cable Beach.
And it's marked by Cable Beach. Beach again trying to clear it out of the Towns forward line. Jelly dropped what she should have taken and it spilled to Towns. And a mark taken for Towns.
Who's got that number four?
That is Vinicum.
Vinicum, yeah.
Vinicum for Towns. Difficult angle. She's right on the boundary line over on the high school side of the ground. The airport end is seeming as though this is the scoring end.
Wind is slightly in the favour down that way. So,
and we see Vinicum taking her time. She puts it through. What's she done with it?
What?
It's a goal.
That's
for
incredible.
Towns.
Wow, all right.
Great goal for Vinicum from Towns.
What a game.
And
that's
they're loving
the
it.
Now. So now that put Towns ahead. Cable Beach 4-4-28. Towns 5-1-31 in this third quarter.
Towns hit the front. It's a 6-minute mark, nearly the 7-minute mark of the third quarter. They did say that this was going to be their quarter, that they have played very good football.
Is that what you heard over there?
I heard that over at the halftime huddle.
Well, look, with that first goal straight off the bat from Cable Beach, I wasn't sure, but, you know, anything could still happen.
Exactly.
Both teams are doing amazingly well.
They're very strong. It's anyone's game, really, Maddie. I wouldn't like to call it at this point in time. I think Cable Beach perhaps are lacking a bit of match play. They've had a couple of forfeits the last couple of weekends.
Well, that's it. And despite training, Towns have been playing the whole time.
You never play that intensity that you do when you're playing in a match.
Yep.
We find it in the Towns forward line again. This time Cable Beach are able to clear it.
Oh, what's on that?
But only as far as Varney. So Varney, Isabel, she's taking a kick out of the defence across to Sanchez, Augustine. Augustine takes a bounce. She elects to go back towards the middle, towards Coffin. Coffin picks it up off one bounce. It bounces. We've got Wilson at the back, behind the ball. Pigram going in underneath, trying the groundwork. Townie's defender waiting for it to come to her, unfortunately. Exactly, Matt. She waited too long and she's been pinged for holding the ball. Parryman picks it up quickly, gets a kick away. Strong kick in the favour of Dan.
Oh, my
Dan
gosh,
picks it up.
Again, Dan.
And
wow.
She's got a goal for okay. Cable Beach. Don't they love it?
This is just, yeah, almost ping pong, as you said earlier.
Yeah, exactly.
Back and forth with the goals.
It's fantastic level of football. Really good quality. It's great to see the women's game providing us with such entertainment.
Cable Beach now just ahead, 5-4, 34. And
Wilson
Towns,
comes
5-1,
off. Carstairs coming on for Cable Beach. Getting ready to get set up again.
3 points of difference.
Even
here.
The people running water seem excited. That's Leanne Blackley for Towns there. She'd be very excited. Very stalwart for the Towns sporting club. They, of course, have switched into netball as well now, Towns, as has Cable Beach. They'll be playing grand finals today over at the BRAC. Meanwhile, the semi-final of the football being played right now, and it's a cracker. Varney with the ball in the centre of the ground, pushes forward for Beach. Picked up by Malardi for Towns. Gubbins again in there for Towns. She's dragged down though with it, and the umpire says, I'll have that. The players spread out a little bit. Just inside the Cable Beach forward line, the Towns have managed to clear it out of there.
Oh, what a
fantastic tackle. Elena Coffin pulls down the Towns player. Calling for 50 metres, but the Townies didn't realise it was against them. Varney gets the kick away, finds Winetti. Winetti spins, puts it on her left, kicks it forward. It's in the forward pocket. Pigram's there, so is Parryman. Spills out to another Beach player. Pigram again with the handball. So we see the men warming up on the outer side, ready for their game coming up next. And the ball is once again back in the centre of the ground. This time, Jamison going at it for Towns. She's fighting Grace John from Cable Beach. Ping pong, all right. It's back and forward footy at Haynes today. The ball way over on the outer side of the ground, the high school side of the ground. It's going to stay in play. With all sorts of hands on it. Cable Beach get a kick away. Dan pushes the player off the ball.
Oh, no. Look out,
Towns. She is so strong. They're saying, push down, push down. Dan takes her time in the end. Pops it up for Carstairs.
Yep.
And Sienna Carstairs has the ball.
Is she going to go for a goal? Or
I would suggest she'll set it up.
Yeah.
Set it up for a goal. Although, as you say, she is on a bit of an angle. Not sure what you'd do.
Get it to Dan, that's what you want to do.
With that, I only have to do right angles for year four maths, so I'm not going with a 90 degree there. She's taken the kick anyway.
Wow.
Is it going to float back in? No, it ends up kicking the behind post. Now, here's a rule for you, Maddie.
Yeah.
If it hits the behind post, it's actually paid as out of bounds on the full and the opposition get the kick in. So there you go. It's no score. No score, and Towns get possession of the ball. They kick as far as Gubbins. She dropped what she should have taken. She's got a Beach attacker on her tail.
Oh, nice mark.
And a
number
great
two.
Running back mark. That's Jelly for Cable Beach. That's their captain, Maddie Jelly. Yeah, Jelly kicks it
lots
off
of energy.
To Coffin. Coffin gets the ball to the... Well, she was attempting to find the lead of Parryman. Parramatta overran it in the end. Towns sort of spoil each other there. Varney picks up the ball and it's on the chest.
Oh, that's not looking good
of
for
Catherine
Towns.
Dan. She plays on quickly.
No, doesn't go for a goal.
To the advantage of Augustine. Augustine picks up the ball.
There it is.
And it's a goal
there
for Cable Beach.
Nice work.
Towns just seemed to stop still then and let that happen.
Kinda.
That's Sanchez Augustine, goal kicker for Cable Beach. And Lani Pigram is happy with that one, as she should be. It puts her a team 9 points clear now. 6-4, 40 to 5-1, 31. That's perhaps the biggest lead of the game.
So far.
With a 12.5-minute mark of the third quarter. The premiership quarter, we like to call it. And it's certainly playing out that way. The winner today going through to the grand final. They get automatic entry to the grand final, which is, of course, being played right here in Broome at Haynes Oval on Saturday, the 11th of September.
Yeah, so if Cable Beach win this, they continue their undefeated streak, at least for the women's team.
Absolutely.
If they don't, then they have to keep playing another game and earn their way into the grand final.
Exactly. So we see play underway again.
Oh, that's...
Gubbins dragged down again. She definitely knows how to play for that one, but nevertheless, she's got herself a free kick. Jamison attempting to get the front position. She does. She dives on top of the ball. She was kind of a Cable Beach sandwich for a minute there. Brooks ends up with the ball, kicks it clear. Great kick from Brooks. Kicks it forward for Towns. Are we going to have an answer from Towns?
Nope.
Oh, picked up beautifully by Cooper. Watson from Cable Beach. And now we find Winnetti with the stabbing pass. She's looking
15.
There for Ferone.
Ferone, that's
it. Ferone unable to just finish off there. Picked up and spun around. We've got an Augustine on the ground here calling for a player to take over from her. Winnetti with the ball for Beach. They're looking for Dan, and she marks truly.
I mean, Dan's got to be
the
star player so far.
She is such a strong player, such a strong player. Why doesn't she back herself, though, and go back and have a kick at goal?
Yeah, no, she likes to set up, I guess, give her other teammates a shot. Never mind, though.
Maybe she doesn't like herself for the distance, but anyway,
back
I think she would. It's back to Dan, back to Winnetti,
back
to Dan. You're all over it, Maddie.
I know, Dan.
Not hard to know when she gets a lot of the ball. She passes it off to Carstairs.
Is that another? This has
and there it is.
Nice ahead.
From Cable Beach.
An extra goal now. Cable Beach 7-4, 46, and Towns 5-1, 31. Look, it's still close, but at this point, Towns really needs to get more of those possessions, have a few more shots.
I'm not sure if they're going to get an answer in the time.
No, not in this quarter.
Before the siren goes to mark three-quarter time as the seconds tick away. I think the ball's going to beat us. And not come back in time. Sienna Carstairs with another goal today. She is well and truly the leading goal kicker for the West Kimberley Footy League Women's. And there it is. The siren sounds to mark the end of the third quarter. What a great couple of goals from Cable Beach to really just put their stamp on this game. Towns are not going anywhere, though. Don't go away. Don't miss a minute, because the quarter coming up, it's going to decide who goes through to play in the grand final. Currently, Cable Beach 7-4, 46, Towns 5-1, 31. Welcome back. This is, we're about to start the fourth quarter of the qualifying final. Well, I like to call it a semi-final. It's 1-2. Cable Beach leading Towns, 46-31 currently. And I've got my resident statistician here. Joining me is Will Cameron.
Hello, Oz. There is a tie in the hitouts, 3-3. Towns winning the clearances, 4-2. And Towns also winning the free kicks, 4-2.
Okay, well, that's interesting. Townies in front in the stats. Not quite on the scoreboard, though. Cable Beach just showing their class at the end of that last third quarter, getting a couple of solid goals in courtesy of Catherine Dan and friends, Sienna Carstairs, and pushed them to the biggest lead of the match, currently 46, leading Towns 31. And I'm joined back in commentary by my mate, Maddie Francis. How are you finding the game, Maddie?
Hey, Roz. Hey, everyone. It's excellent. The energy in the game has been fantastic. If I can say, though, it looks like the energy was pretty equal between the two teams in the first couple of quarters, but that last one, Cable Beach still had the momentum going, and Saints just lost it a little bit.
I think you've hit the nail on the head there. It's all about momentum in games. In a game I was coaching the other night at netball, we had a ball go over the fence and into the car park. And just that time that it took them to retrieve the ball or get another ball, that held time, we lost our momentum and ended up losing the game by 2 goals. Ooh. But anyway, not that I'm bitter at all. All right, it is all about momentum. Let's see who has what it takes
last
to see
quarter.
Them through to
it.
The grand final. As we see the ball up in the middle of the ground and a clear win then from the, looked like Tess Seward taking the ruck tap. And they're going to go yet again up against Long for Towns. No clear winner that time as the ball is on the ground yet again. Bev Edgar sockers it off the ground, tries to push it forward for Varney to pick up. But Varney's under pressure from Kennedy. Kennedy gets the ball clear from Towns. It's back in the centre of the ground with Coffin diving all over it. What a surprise. What a game we've had here today. That's Maddie Jelly for Cable Beach as well as Townies kick forward again. It lands in the safe hands of Kira Watson for Cable Beach. Watson kicks forward for Beach. She's looking for Winetti. Winetti's got the pace. Excellent soccer player is Tui Winetti. She does all right on the football field as well. Gets a high up and under kick and it's marked strongly by the Towns defender who pushes it back in the
Could have marked that, plays it on.
Brooks' direction. Brooks unable to mark, but she does get a strong kick away. It's not marked again. We're in front of the broadcast wing. Got great vision here. Jamison. Dan with the kick away. Dan kicks it, and it's a great kick from Vinicum. Great mark from Vinicum. And Towns on the hunt now. Wow, what an awesome one-handed mark. Has been paid
27.
That's Blair Gronenberg. Hasn't really featured in this game too much today, Gronenberg. But she was able to hold off her defender with one hand and mark with the other. In the end, elects to handball away, this time to Jamison. Jamison back to Gronenberg, gets another stab at it. Gronenberg again, this time it's quite close to the boundary line. And it's going to be Towns Jamison who kicks it around to the advantage of Gubbins. Gubbins gets a beautiful kick away. But
is anyone there,
across
though?
The face of the goal, and it's a Beach defender.
Yep.
That kicks it back. A bit of ping pong footy here again at Haynes Oval. So the ball's going back and forward. We're in the Towns forward line. They're fighting hard. Just catch up that deficit they currently suffer to Cable Beach. And it looks like Watson again fighting hard for Beach. The kick's away, it's play on, I thought. I think the umpire's still putting his hands up saying play on, play on. And we find the ball in the safe hands of Leanne Gubbins. Gubbins is going to line up for goal. I'm not sure she's got the distance here, so we'll be interested to see the movement that's going on in the goal square to see is anyone going to pop forward for a lead for her or
Gubbins
at least be there for the crumbs. Gubbins kicks
in. Never mind.
Beautiful big kick. It's got the distance, but not quite the accuracy. A little bit to the left. It's still in play, the ball. Ball's on the ground.
They got to call that. Yep.
And the umpire says, yes, please. I'll sort
that.
Out this mess for you. And we'll have another ball up. Not sure who's saying they'll do the ruck tap. A bit of a mess in the end. The ball going towards the boundary line where Brooks picks it up for Towns. Puts it on her boot. Is that a goal? That's a miraculous goal from Townies. Yes,
what
it is.
An illusion. Yes,
that
was a goal.
That is awesome. Great kick from Brooks. Well played. Tegan Brooks, she's picked the ball
lovely
up
goal.
Quite close to the boundary line. She's switched to the other foot and kicked a check side kick. I think that's the terminology for it. It's a great kick, whatever you call it.
I wouldn't have called it, but it's definitely a goal. And
it went through for a goal.
7-4, 46 Towns. For Cable Beach. Towns now 6-1, 37.
They're not going away, Towns. Plenty of time left for them to catch up.
Yeah, 9 points of difference.
37 to 46, 99 points. Thanks, Matt, for the maths there.
Yep, I was in primary school too a while back.
Well, that's about the level of my maths. I'm teaching primary school maths. That's about where it stays. I've learned some good tricks, though. The ball goes up again. Play is underway, pushing again forward for Towns. Bev Edgar picks it up. And onto the boot by Jelly. Jelly for Beach, but only as far as Towns. And Towns, Leanne Gubbins has the ball again. This time a little toe poke kick as far as Brooks. Brooks plays on, kicks it forward to the advantage of her player. Almost
that could
for
have
Vinicum.
Been beautiful.
Vinicum dropped what she should have taken. She was under a lot of pressure from Augustine, though. The ball spills free. Mary Dan's there for Towns. Can she pick it up and do something with it? No, the defence is just too strong, too hard. They're ending up on the ground more often than not. And the ball is in another huddle again. This time the kick away from Cable Beach. Brooks is chasing it, as is Ferone. Ferone tripped just at the vital moment. Picked up by Gubbins. Gubbins did a bit of tap, tap, tappity tap. And the umpire has called for holding the player. So interesting there. Gubbins ends up with another free kick. And she's looking goalward. Although I'm not sure she's got the distance. Here comes the lead now.
This must be set up.
The lead from Vinicum. Cut off beautifully by Augustine of Beach. And Augustine now looks for a teammate to clear it out of trouble. Only as far as the punch away from Gubbins.
Oh, looks like the player might be down. Nope.
Yeah, I think that's Jelly for Cable Beach. She's probably content to just get her breath back for a minute or two. Edgar Socker's off the ground. Winnetti with possession of the ball. Turns around. Remember, she's going the other way for Beach. Steps towards Ferone. Ferone with the hand pass back to Winnetti. Winnetti in favour of Dan. It overruns Dan, but Pigram's there. Lani Pigram picks up the ball. A great kick off the boot of Lani Pigram. Over the top behind for Carstairs. And it dribbles through for a behind. What a disappointment for Cable Beach. That was an awesome set passage of play. What a shame they couldn't finish it off with a goal. It goes through for a behind. Cable Beach 7-5, 47. Town 6-1, 37. 10 points the difference. As we're near the 7-minute mark for the West Kimberley Footy League semi-final here today. It's 1-2. Cable Beach undefeated going into today's match. Will they continue their undefeated run against Towns today? Towns looking to assert themselves and hope they can make it straight in to a grand final in 2 weeks' time. Got some technical difficulties at the moment with our sound, but hopefully you can still hear me. I'll just keep on talking. Be rude not to. As the ball gets thrown in from the cricket net side, the high school side of Haynes Oval here in Broome. Little bit of a breeze swirling around the oval now, but nothing too much to interfere with the play. Pigram fighting hard for the ball again, diving over the top. Wilson picks it up, handballs out to Winnetti. Winnetti strongly tackled, but she's able to shrug that tackle. Gets the ball onto her left foot in the direction of Dan. Dan not able to pick it up off the ground. She's held heavily by the Towns defender. Towns trying to scoop it up. Goes to Brooks, goes to Kennedy. Kennedy gets a kick away. Well played, Shelby Kennedy, for Towns. And the ball runs towards Ferone.
Ferone, 15.
She's picked up the ball and she's been pinged for holding the ball. That's a little bit tough. I don't know that she had enough time to
even do anything with it. Yep. But
she had enough time to get rid of it. But that's what the umpire's seen. That's what they've called. And it lands in the hands of Janika Long for Towns. Long kicks forward. Marked by Vinicum. Vinicum plays on quickly. Here we go. Mary Dan's under it. But she's stopped by Augustine. That's Marcia. Marshy able to get the kick away, but it comes back
lovely.
To the Towns player. Unfortunately, Long just came off the side of her boot and the ball not going where she wanted it to. That's Watson for Beach. Clears it out of the defence. We're still in the Towns forward line, the Towns forward pocket, as Ferroni attempts to clear the ball out for Beach. Strong tackle laid on Brooks. Wilson able to pick up the ball, but only to the lone Towns player of Kennedy. Shelby Kennedy takes her time to get the kick away. And it's marked, strong mark by Brooks. Why don't they just slow down and take their time, Towns? I'm not sure. But anyway, they're playing on. Trying to look around the Beach bench here to see the action. As Coffin, casual as you like, does a handball from hands and knees. As far as Augustine, Augustine sockers it off to the advantage of Jelly. Jelly to Winetti. Winetti kicks forward to the advantage of Pigram. Picked up by Dan. How many times have we seen that today? Dan to Pigram. One bounce, two bounce, went a bit awry, ran into the Town's defender. Still in possession, this time with Carstairs. Carstairs will run into an open goal and bang! Cable Beach.
It's hard not to cheer for that. She just had a clear goal, ran straight for it. Lovely clear work. That was nice. So Cable Beach now just scored another goal. And that puts them way ahead. Cable Beach 8-5-53. Towns looking 6-1-37 in the fourth quarter with not a lot of time left.
Not a lot of time left, but Towns certainly have the momentum. They had the ball in their forward half for a good deal of time there. Just not able to convert. Cable Beach just showing their class. Picked up by Dan. Handball off to Pigram. Pigram tried to do a couple of bounces. Messed it up a little bit, but it still fell in favour for Carstairs, the leading goal kicker, and she was able to get another goal on the board and put her team Beach.
Brooks was injured not too long ago. She's still sticking around and playing, but
she doesn't look too well.
No, she doesn't look too well at all.
Not too keen to come off either, so we'll see what happens
there.
Here we go. We've got the runner going out to her now. As Gubbins kicks the ball clear, Vinicum attempts to mark a dodgy bounce in the end, and it's kicked away by Abby Dorfling. She's played a strong mark. I think I've called her as Winetti a couple of times. They look quite similar out there. Anyway, Dorfling in defence
for
Beach.
Brooke, number 8, replaced with number 15, Malati. Hayley Malati coming in for the Towns at the moment for the last few minutes of the game.
Thanks, Matt. Another strong tackle landed by Beach. And Townies players are dropping left, right and centre.
It's not good.
The ball now in possession of Cable Beach with Coffin with the ball. Just wait to see what happens with this injury. The player is down.
Times pause for now while they make sure the
just
players
pause.
Are right.
Exactly. So she's got her knee up. Could just be... they're calling for the stretcher. That big... looks like the stretcher needs to get run out. We might ask Will to help them with the stretcher, running it out, to see if they need...
No, they got it. A couple of able-bodied men.
Excellent.
No, Will would have done it, though. He's a legend like that.
Absolutely. So you're listening to Roslyn Butcher and Matt Francis. We're live at Haynes Oval on the radio. And if you are a footy fan, you can catch the replay on GTV or through Galari Media YouTube Thursday night on GTV. So this is the first semi-final for the women's. It's 1 versus 2, 3 versus 4 Luma and Bombers playing later on today at 1:30. Next weekend, we have the preliminary final, which is the loser of 1 versus 2, so whoever loses today, versus the winner of 3 versus 4. And we'll see what happens pushing forward, of course, to the grand final being played men's and women's on Saturday, the 11th of September. In the end, the stretcher not needed, I don't think.
Slowly, the player's still getting off the field, or... How are we looking with that?
Well,
play's continuing.
Play has restarted.
Yeah,
all
here
right,
we go.
So Coffin with the ball. She's kicked it forward to Jelly. Jelly gets it on the boot. Not able to mark by Dan. Great defence being played against Dan today. And it spills to the Beach player there. Surely that's not Sienna Carstairs again. She added to her total
Cable
yet
Beach
again.
Players and fans very excited now as that puts them
Cable Beach.
Enough in the lead to...
I'd say we could probably call it at this point, although
Anything could happen. Look, hypothetical. Let's say Cable Beach makes it through and Towns doesn't. They'll need to replay again next week.
That's right.
Yep. And who would they be versing then? I guess it's a bit hard to say.
Next week? Well, my money's on Luma,
okay.
Actually, this afternoon, 3-4, because Bombers were beaten by Bulls last weekend. Not a good sign when you're going into finals. But you never know. Anything can happen in finals. As we see the ball in play again, Gubbins trying to soccer it off the ground, not able to do so. In the end, her teammate Perry dives on the ball and the umpire says, I'll have that for a ball up. Number 31, Long for Town, says, yes, please, I'll do the ruck work here. She's going up against Seaward Tess for Cable Beach. The ball spills out to Winetti again. I've really been impressed with the Town's defence today. Really play a strong brand of football. Winetti picks up the ball off the ground. She gets onto her left foot. She's looking for Dan. Dan takes the mark, plays on.
Oh, wow.
And she's kicked the goal.
Incredible. There you go. Dan, I mean.
Luckily, she didn't put quite as much oomph on that as she may have, as it might have ended up over onto Frederick Street. But yes, Catherine Dan, very happy as we see the caravans rolling on by. Familiar sight in Broome at the moment with thousands and thousands of visitors in town.
Look at that Broome.
Tell you what.
Peak traffic jam over there.
Peak traffic jam, exactly. If you were in Broome at the moment, you are one of the lucky ones. And you are even luckier if you are here today watching this stellar game of football. Semi-final West Kimberley Footy League women's action. Cable Beach in the lead, 65, beg your pardon, leading Towns, 37.
Not that long ago, it was so close as well. Cable Beach just got some great momentum, kept it going. Towns lost energy and also a few players as well out with injuries. Really didn't help over this last couple of quarters.
You see the ball back in the centre of the ground again. Gubbins ends up with it. Gee, she's got a great kick on her. But unfortunately, she kicks it to Augustine of Beach. Strong player in defence
today. Yeah, she's
been
great defence for Cable Beach.
Overrun Stewart.
Steph, 15.
Picked up by Ferrone, one of your mates, Maddie. And then in the end, it's kicked clear by Natasha Kenworthy for Towns. But lands in the lap of Augustine. Yet again.
At this point, Cable Beach can just sort of have a bit of a play, and they've got it.
That's right.
There it is.
And there it is.
And
there it is.
All the Cable Beach team extremely excited about that. The fans as well. Congratulations, of course, Cable Beach for winning this particular round. They've got Cable Beach 10, 565, Towns 6137. And we've got young Will, who's been busy in the background running some stats. You want to have a chat?
Sure, Will. I will. I'll let Will get set up with his headphones as we see the celebrations for Cable Beach, who go in to play yet another grand final clash. So they have secured their spot today in the grand final for the Women's West Kimberley Footy League with a great win over Towns, 10-5-65, Towns 6-1-37. How did you see the game, Will?
Yeah, great win from Beach there. Tying their hit-outs 2-2, also tying the clearances 2-2, and Towns winning free kicks 2-0.
Awesome. Thanks so much for your efforts today, Will, and also throughout the season. As we look forward to some more finals footy action coming up on Radio Galari and also through Galari Media and TV. You can search for us on YouTube as well. So today, Cable Beach victorious in this 1-2 semi-final. Later on today, Luma will play Bombers in 3-4, with the winner of that going through to play today's loser, Towns. By no means a loser though, Towns. Played a very strong game.
Strong game.
Unfortunately, just losing the momentum in the end.
And
Cable
Beach,
again, though. Too strong.
Next week, eh?
Exactly, yes. So the preliminary final coming up next week. We know that Towns will be playing. Who they'll be playing will be decided later on today. For me, though, it's time for me to sign out. Thanks so much for your company. My name's Roslyn Butcher. I've been joined by Maddie Francis. Thanks,
That's
Maddie.
Me. It's been a pleasure. Thanks, Ros. It's great getting to share some radio space with you.
Absolutely. And catch up with everybody next time. Galia.
Galia.